We got breaking news out of Luhansk, Ukraine. The Russian convoy of 280 trucks has reached the border of Luhansk, which is being controlled by the rebels. There was heavy shelling overnight in the area, and who knows how many civilians have died. I would say the Ukrainian government was trying to retake the border because they want to block that convoy so they can send in their own convoy of food and other supplies after they've been bombing someone. It is a tactic. It was used during the Irish famine. The British starved the Irish and then fed them and supplied them with jobs. While they starved to death or starving, they made them work on roads. In other words, it goes back to don't bite the hand that feeds you. And in that part of the world, Ukraine, there is still a lot of communism going on where the government provides. Even in Western Ukraine, they were living off of subsidies. There was a story today in the New York Times, where they talked about pre-Maidan, the average Ukrainian soldier made something like $750 a month. Now he makes $100 a month. Just a couple weeks ago, or a week ago, Ukrainian soldiers fighting in eastern Ukraine crossed the border in Russia to go get something to eat. Now, you've got radical groups like Right Sector who will want that food for themselves. You have the regular Ukrainian army who are probably starving. Meanwhile, Petro Poroshenko has billions of dollars, yet he has to go demand that the United States pay for all this. He has to go to the IMF and say, we need more money. He has to go to his fist-throwing, call it Congress, to raise taxes on the Ukrainian people on gas. They will effectively, I guess, pay twice as much in gas to pay for the war in the East. What's it all about? Gas. There's gas in eastern Ukraine, and NATO, Europeans, they want that gas, but they want it under the control of someone they can manipulate. They don't want it under the control of Russia. And that's what this is all about. Russia doesn't care about the eastern Ukrainians, because if they did, they would have intervened a long time ago. They're waiting for Ukraine to go bomb the convoy, shell it, stop it, do whatever, as justification to go in there to go seize that oil field or gas field. In all the industrial area, because that's where Ukraine's whole industrial complex is. It's in the east, it's not in the west. In the west they do nothing. They wait for checks to come in. So we are at the flashpoint. Ukraine is trying to send aid in from their own three cities, and Russia is at the border where the people need it most. Do the people actually want to get food and supplies from Western Ukraine after they've been bombing them and killing all their family off, driving their friends and family away? I don't think they do. But Russia is there already, and this could be the flashpoint that starts the war. The Russian people don't want intervention there, but this could start it.